Reverse mechanic.
Breaking it down.
I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. Until I choke. Until I choke. Oh,
I tried to play it safe, always keeping it in, protected by a solid body down deep in the skin. But now we can begin to realize that in essence, our brains, our cells, and ribs cage the repression. So I'll shove my soul through this hole in my throat, let it float from its detention. Hope it finds connection in this cold, cold world through simple self-expression. I'll start with a confession. I've grown a lot personally since the first impression. Seen the worst depression, ups and downs. Learned some life lessons, been turned upside down. But what I've found is being vulnerable is free. It's hard and unnerving, but it's good for your well-being. And now I'm finally seeing being tough's not keeping things in. No, it's quite the opposite. It's the things out and people in by talking about all of it. Things out and people in by talking about all of it.
I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat.
I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat.
Until I choke. Until I choke.
Has a real nice sound to it, but life makes me nervous, so I'm not consoled. I don't know if I'm up to it, cause when it comes right down to it, there's a whole lot we cannot control, and I can't stand it. So I sit and share the stories that bear my soul, like there I go. Sometimes life seems unfair, I know. Like I remember praying in church alone, kneeling after meeting someone freshman year that really had me reeling. No concealing how I feel, I told myself she gave me feelings, so I wrote a song about her, couldn't wait for the revealing. But before I ever showed her, she found someone more appealing. Got a lump in my throat, my soul was pushing on the ceiling of its cage, like damn dude, just tell her what you're feeling. But I swallowed it down hard and watched as she was sealing the deal. I couldn't deal, she didn't know what I was dealing with.
I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. I shoved my soul through this hole in my throat. Until I choke. Until I choke.
Uncertain. My uncle seems so young when cancer closed the curtain. I know my dad's been hurting, chemo is a burden. The doctors and the surgeons all say that they've determined that he'll live with it from here on. But God, he don't deserve it. He's been a loyal servant with uncommon honesty, a constantly astonishing anomaly of quality. It ripped the soul from my throat the nights I heard him vomiting. Hoped my soul could convey my love, and it clung to the words that dripped off my tongue like an IV. Not shyly bottling it up, but forcing it out, pushing four words forward out of my mouth. I love you, Dad, I want to confess. So God bless this wholehearted public address that lets me bare my soul and get the shit off my chest.
I shut my soul through this hole in my throat. I shut my soul through this hole in my throat. I shut my soul through this hole in my throat. Until I choke. Until I
put a pen to paper, was just second nature. A young second grader writing classic tales about a monster invader and a confident savior with that little kid flavor. Now all these years later, I still have the passion, still have the need to tell stories and imagine. Still get satisfaction putting stories into action, but now I'd rather tell real stories with compassion. This hole in my throat lets you see my insides better than x-rays or MRIs could ever reveal. 'Twas about damn time that my lips are unsealed. It's unreal how fantastic open space feels. So I'll let my soul out, so there's no doubt that I will shove my soul through this hole in my throat till I choke.